They don't know the difference between a bump stock, a semi-automatic, or a machine gun. The reason they're so out of touch is because their education level as it relates to firearms is that of this asshole who said, I tell my wife to take a double-barreled shotgun and fire it into the air indiscriminately. I am hunting pesky Republicans.
I do want to hear Elizabeth Warren since she's now leading the polls.
Go for it.
The totem pole.
Let's start by framing around the right here. We have a gun violence problem in this country. The mass shootings are terrible, but they get all the headlines. Children die every day on streets, neighborhoods, on playgrounds.
Shut up, pay attention.
People die from violence, from suicide.
You don't.
90% of Americans want to
really
see
don't.
Us do. I like registration.
Let's be really clear about this. Everybody else shut up, because I have to go down on this really quickly. I've got to go down this trail. Just recently, I was listening to somebody saying, and it was the Young Turks, I believe. The Young Turks and who else was it? I'm just trying to think of who it was. It was someone's, the recent Ted Cruz with Alyssa Milano.
Yeah.
With Alyssa Milano and her little, I don't know, her white knighting guy with him, who kept bringing up that he had a daughter who died in Florida. They said, okay, listen, Mr. Cruz, you keep trying to straw man, that's a red herring. Nobody wants a gun registry. Nobody wants a buyback.
Oops.
And he tried, hold on a second. There are three people on this stage right now who want a mandatory gun buyback. Here's something that's important for people to note. You know who's not amongst them? Is Elizabeth Warren. But what does she support? The very first step in how you carry out a buyback, which is a registry. The only way you can do a mandatory buyback, which is what they're referring to, which is an all-out gun ban when they're talking about Australia, is by knowing who has guns. And you start that with a registry. So we have Cory Booker, we have Beto O'Rourke. I can't remember who the third guy is up on that stage who supports an outright Australian gun ban. And now we have the number one front runner of the DNC supporting a gun registry who's so purpose is to determine who is allowed and not allowed to own firearms. By the way, none of you should be allowed to own firearms according to Heller versus DC. There is no private citizenship right to own a firearm. This is important for people to know. It's not some extreme fringe leftist. I hate when you have these people go, the truth is somewhere in the middle. Oh, people, no, listen. They go, why don't Republicans budge? Because we don't want to budge in a registry, because the rest of the people on the stage support using a registry to to ban firearms. So we say that's a bridge too far, is the registry. So what do? They say, what about these universal background? Hold on a second, we already have background checks. What are you talking about with your background checks? Read the fine print. It's a registry. Then read the fine print on their website, and they believe in using that registry to remove your right to own a firearm because you've taken a Xanax, or because at some point in your life you've taken an antidepressant. And then the next guy who takes office believes that you shouldn't have firearms at all, period. So they say, no, this is, go watch that. We're going to do a whole segment on this, the Ted Cruz, Alyssa Milano interview. They were saying, no, we all support the Second Amendment. Yeah. No one believes that people should be stripped of firearms. Well, Beto only believes in AR-15s. But half of these people believe in a firearm registry. Half of them believe in firearms not being able to have 10 rounds or more. I think some of them believe in less than 8 rounds, by the way, which might exclude some revolvers. You have an infringement on your rights. This is how it starts. The Second Amendment isn't absolute. The Supreme Court, Heller versus DC, determined that the Second Amendment is absolute. The arguments against it were that no private citizen has the right to own arms whatsoever. So that's the first step. The next step is a gun registry, so you know who, where, and how many guns people have. And the next step is an outright mandatory gun ban. Some people say, well, I don't want to live in the what-ifs, the fear-mongering. Hold on a second. It's not fear-mongering. If any of the top candidates on this stage, if they actually had the balls, they probably don't, just like everyone who says, I'm going to end the wars, they have the first Homeland Security briefing and say, get my brown pants. Yeah. But right now, according to every single main person on the stage, if they had their way, you would no longer have firearms. So don't say it's fringe. They just told you what it is that they want to do. It doesn't matter if they claim that most Americans support their policies. They don't. Most Americans support some kind of a background check. We already have them. Most Americans think there shouldn't be some kind of an online loophole. You shouldn't be able to own a you shouldn't be able to purchase a firearm online without a background check. You're not allowed to do that. So it's very, very important to note when people say it's a fringe movement, you say, okay, what's fringe? Is it Joe Biden? Is it Elizabeth Warren? Is it Bernie Sanders, Cory Booker, Beto O'Rourke, Amy Klobuchar? Which one of them is extreme? Because the problems that I have are with all of their policies. And I think it's important that people note that. Oh, no one wants to take your guns. They just said it. They just said it.
Yeah.
So how do you feel about guns?
Yeah, but the funny thing with the Beto one is that he was interviewed by a reporter who tried giving him an out. It's like, well, what do you say to all these rubes who think they're going to say, like, oh, well, you're trying to take their guns, but you're not trying to take their guns, are you? And Beto's answer was, let me be clear. We're going to take their guns.
And by the way, crystal clear.
The reason they're so out of touch is because their education level as it relates to firearms is that of this asshole who said, I tell my wife to take a double-barreled shotgun and fire it into the air indiscriminately. He believes that safer than an AR-15 in the hands of a trained woman like my wife, or too cute Maddie, by the way, who works here, half the people who work here, that someone with an AR-15 trained on a bad guy, he believes that that is less safe than his wife, who likely at this point has some neurodegenerative decline, let's be honest, if she's even the better half of Joe Biden, going out with a double-barreled shotgun like Elmer Fudd going, I am hunting pesky Republicans. This is what this guy thinks is appropriate. Right. These are the people who believe they don't know the difference between a bump stock, a semi-automatic, or a machine gun. Either they don't know or they deliberately obfuscate. They deliberately want you not to know. Yeah. And that's why the gun issue is so important, because it is the most dishonest issue.
Yes. Yeah.
It's easy to appeal people by saying, I'm going to give you free stuff. You're not necessarily lying. You're just not telling them how you're going to pay for it. But when you tell people, I don't want to take away your guns. I just want a registry and a mandatory buyback. You're lying to them.
Hey there, YouTube viewers. Subscribe to the channel. Hit the notification bell if you're already subscribed to this channel, because that lets you know when new videos come out and they don't show up on the YouTube search feed. Also, there are videos playing in boxes here. Click one of those. Just of all the things that I just mentioned, all you have to do is one. And if you don't, I will run for the United States presidency under the 1,064th percent Cherokee Party. I have yet to pick my VP.